Good day, everybody. Today we are going to discuss about volumetric strain, and I am Vijayalakshmi from TPGIT Vellore. So, before venturing into volumetric strain, let us just review about the basic points once again. Longitudinal strain. So, the longitudinal strain is generally caused due to the tensile or the compressive load, and it takes place along the direction of loading. Lateral strain, the strain which takes place at right angles to the applied load. And then shear strain, which is caused due to the shear force acting on a material. Poisson's ratio. So Poisson's ratio is defined as the ratio between the lateral strain and the longitudinal strain. So this says how much the dimensions shrink when the other dimension is expanding, vice versa. And volumetric strain. So the volumetric strain is the ratio of change in the volume to the original volume when the body is acted upon by a single force or a system of forces. So let us consider the case of a volumetric strain of a rectangular bar subjected to an axial load in the direction of length. Now, due to the load acting, there is an increase in length in the direction of load, and that strain is called as longitudinal strain. Due to the increase in the length, there is a simultaneous decrease in the width and thickness. These are called as lateral strains. Hence, volumetric strain is equal to longitudinal strain into 1 minus 2 into mu, where mu is equal to Poisson's ratio. So let us consider the case of a rectangular bar which is subjected to 3 mutual perpendicular forces along x, y and z directions. So the force along x direction creates a longitudinal strain in x and lateral strain in y and z. That is, if it expands in length, there is a decrease in the width and the thickness. That is, an increase in the length along x and decrease in length along y and z. Similarly, force along y creates a longitudinal strain in y and lateral strain in x and z. That is, an increase in length along y direction and a decrease in length along x and z direction. And a force along z direction creates a longitudinal strain in z direction and lateral strain in x and z. That is, the length increases along z and decreases along y and x. So the total volumetric strain is equal to, for each and everything, it is sigma x into 1 minus 2 mu. So you have 1 by e into sigma x plus sigma y plus sigma z into 1 minus 2 mu, where sigma x, sigma y and sigma z or stresses along x, y and z directions respectively. Generally, volumetric strain is considered positive if there is an increase in the volume and is considered negative whenever there is a decrease in the volume. Now, we can see the importance of the volumetric strain while discussing about the bulk modulus. Like modulus of elasticity, rigidity modulus, we have one more modulus called as bulk modulus. So the modulus of elasticity gives an idea about the force that is required to produce a deformation in the longitudinal direction or along the direction of application of load. Similarly, the bulk modulus gives an idea about how much force that you have to apply to produce a change in the volume. And by definition, analytically, we generally discuss bulk modulus is equal to direct stress by volumetric strain. So, generally, materials with higher bulk modulus require more force, since you see from the expression, if volumetric strain is equal to 1 or say some constant, then bulk modulus is directly proportional to the direct stress, where stress is equal to force by area. So, bulk modulus is directly proportional to the force. So, material with higher bulk modulus require more force to produce a volume change, and vice versa, that is, materials with lower bulk modulus require less force to produce a volume change. Hence, this bulk modulus plays a very important role in forming process where you bring apply force and bring about a change in the shape. So that is the main significance of bulk modulus. Yes, thank you.